How to gain more clarity on what career is best suited for our interest?
This is the confusion every 10th standard student is having. This is the confusion our 12th standard student is also having. This is the confusion your father and mother is also having. You go and ask. They are all working in software company. Just ask them, are you happy? Ore work pressure pa. Then to get pressure only you get graduated. Yes or no? The point is, career choices should be mapped based on your inner calling. That inner calling will come by attending this kind of sessions. When I'm speaking about IPS, you get an idea about IPS. One day you want to be an IPS. On the other day you want to be an engineer. Because pakkathu vittu anna akka is engineer. And third day when you saw a robot, you want to be a robotic engineer. This confusion is set to happen. You have to pray to the God to show you inner calling, which suits you. Now she was right in the morning, the IPS officer. For to become a bureaucrat in this nation, you need not have great minds. In the sense, great marks. Average knowledge is fine. You just have to work on that strategy. So, 10th standard is the right time. In fact, this is the right camp to think about. Probably in the next, maybe your next batch, I'll try to do it. I do something called designing the career. Where I first show the problems of the country. One day fully, problems of the country is a session. And student will never be, will not be bored. I did it in the one of the schools. 300 students were intact for 8 hours. Of course, breaks were there. 2 breaks only. Okay, so they were able to understand the problem. After they understand the problem, they know as a biomedical engineer, how do they solve the problem of the country? As a civil engineer, how to solve the problem of the country? As a teacher, how to solve the problem of the country? When they understand the higher ideals and when they look at the opportunity, then they understand. First, you should know before choosing a career, how many careers are there in India? Yes or no? Do you know what biomedical engineer does? Do you know what biotech engineer does? Do you know what a software engineer exactly does at office? Apart from drinking tea. You don't know. You should know. For information, my dear friends, in Anna University website itself, 89 different varieties of engineering is there. Like different dosa. It has different role to play. In TNAU, Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, they have something called B.Tech Agriculture Engineering. How many of them know the value of agriculture engineering? The future of India is going to be dependent on agriculture, not on software. Everybody has to be fed food, no? And this food has to be, for example, Nagapattinam problem is there now because of Gaja relief, the Gaja cyclone. Now, to rectify this, we need people from the agriculture industry to go and work there. The point is, do we have resources? No. So software is not the only thing. So first step as an advice to you, as a child who is looking at career planning, first, understand what are the careers available. Don't look at the salary. If you look at the salary, 40,000 rupees, and Anna is earning. He's got, Akka is getting that iPhone. Then your life will only be equal to the iPhone. Keep that away. Then choose based on your interest and contribution to the country. Automatically, that will become your career path. And don't follow the masses. If you don't follow the masses itself, 90% you are successful. 90%. If you don't follow the masses. If you regret that you did not follow the masses, 100% will be a failure. You have to follow your passion. That soul satisfaction, which gives you idea. So put your salary in the dustbin. Idea of salary. Think about how, what interests you. Sports, dance, whatever. And then look at that as a career. This is my advice to you. This is the right time in December. You have time up to April. You can choose between science and commerce. Yeah, this is my suggestion.